Hi everyone, it's Renee from Keep Simple Stuff. Today I just wanted to share with you this heart-shaped starter necklace, which is perfect for the summer. As far as materials go, I'm going to be using red polymer clay, and I'm using the brand Sculpey3. Going to be using green Sculpey3 and yellow. You just need bits of it, but still you need some. I'm using, showing you my clay conditioning machine. You don't need to, but I just bought it because I thought it was pretty cool, but you can use a roller as well. I'm going to be using a really thin gold chain. We will need 2 bead tips and 1 clasp. Going to be using my pliers and my cutters. The cutters is to just cut the chain. A really thin brush for some details towards the end, and water-based gold acrylic paint. The first thing we're going to be using is our red clay, and we're going to shape it into the shape of a snake or a sausage. Here I'm just showing you 4 inches, but I ended up cutting a bit more of that. Once I had that, I started working on the shape of my heart. I started from the bottom part and kind of making a UB, and then making my 2 ends meet at the middle, so they would make the heart shaped. And I'm just smoothing everything with my Ziploc bag. Then I'm grabbing some yellow clay and I'm using small bits. This will be making the seeds, so just as many as you want to, and just make them into small tiny balls. And then you just have to place them randomly wherever you want your seeds to be, and it depends on how many you want and where you want them to be. So just, this is totally optional and you can go as random as you want to. We have done that. We're going to be rolling our green clay through the clay machine, which is basically a pasta machine, and I just love how it looks. That's why I think that's why I love it so much. I'm going to be cutting just as much as I need to, is 1 inch, because that's with my strawberry. Then I'm just going to cut the parts that I don't need with my X-Acto knife. And then I'm just going to cut small tiny UVs, totally random as well, just to make the illusion that it is actually leaves in such things. And again, go totally random, because you're basically simulating nature, so as random as you can. You're going to just put it on top and just start smoothing it with your fingers. Sometimes it breaks. This one actually broke, as you can see, but it doesn't really matter. You can always go ahead and fix it with your fingers, and just stop whenever you're happy with what you have before we bake. This is the final step before we bake, and I'm just going to grab a piece of wire and I'm just going to make a hole through the clay so I can actually use it as a necklace. And I decided to use a piece of wire because it's a bit thinner than a toothpick, and a toothpick might make my piece too sensitive and it might break. So just go ahead and do that. Insert your pin through the clay until you have a hole where your actual chain can go through. And before we bake, we're going to be actually testing if actually our, you know, chain can go through the whole thing. And in this case, it can. So I'm just going to go ahead and bake it according to my clay instructions. Okay, so while that's being baked and cooled, I'm going to grab my chain and I'm going to grab bead tip, and I'm just going to put my chain through the small tiny hole through there, and I'm just going to close it with the pressure of my fingers, and I'm just going to then give it more pressure with my pliers, so this way I'm sure that my chain will just stay in place. So once my piece has left the oven and it's cold, I'm just going to go with my thin brush and I'm just going to paint my seeds, just so they match my chain and so it looks kind of cuter. You don't really have to do it, this is optional, but I just thought it would look cute, and I just gave it a couple of coats, and I just let it dry. Once it was dry, I just put it through my chain, and then secured the other end with my bead tip and with my pliers. This time though, in order to make this a necklace, I'm just going to open the small tiny loop of my clasp, and I'm just going to put my bead tip through that loop, and then I'm going to secure it with my pliers, and that's pretty much it. I just thought of sharing this one because I thought it was super easy to make, and the result or the end product is super cool and cute for the summer. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this one, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to check out all my links that you're watching right now on your right side of the screen, and take care.